In this video, I'm gonna break down how much protein you should be consuming. Let's start with the FDA. The FDA recommendations are extremely low and too generic, especially for those who resistance train. Even if you don't work out, 50 grams is far too low for many people and not supported by science. Fortunately, we have tons of solid research on this topic. A systemic review done by top industry experts Brad Schoenfield, Menno Henselmans, Eric Helms, Alan Aragon, and James Krager showed for muscle building purposes, you'll get the most benefit from 1.6 grams per kilogram daily, but can extend up to 2.2 grams per kilogram. Any more than this is not harmful, but just isn't going to create more muscle. This paper by the Journal of International Society of Sports Nutrition confirmed the same range, with 1.6 to 2.2 kilograms being the optimal range for protein consumption while maintaining or bulking. So if you've been following FDA recommendations, you're probably a weak twig and need to start eating more protein. If, on the other hand, you're a meathead bro who's been piling protein shakes and steaks down your throat, the extra protein isn't damaging, just kind of redundant. So be careful about how much money you're losing to protein. Generally speaking, the lower range is for more experienced lifters and the higher range is for beginner lifters, as these two studies show. This is because of two reasons. First, as you get more experienced, your body becomes more efficient with utilizing protein, therefore needing less than a beginner to maximize the same benefits. The second reason is because the beginner has more muscle to be built. As you advance in training, you build less and less muscle, thus needing less protein than a beginner who has a lot of muscle to be built when they first start. Top scientist Eric Helms also points out when bulking, aiming for higher protein would also be for people who tend to overeat in the off season and want to limit their calorie consumption to prevent excess fat gain. So generally, studies show when maintaining or bulking, 1.6 grams per kilogram to be a very solid amount to maximize your gains, with 2.2 grams per kilogram being an even safer number to shoot for, especially if you're a beginner or someone worried about gaining too much fat on a bulk. When it comes to cutting, aka fat loss, you actually need more protein than when you're bulking. Many people think you need more protein during a bulk than during a cut, but the opposite is actually true. The reason for this is because when you're dieting down, protein breakdown increases as your body is in a caloric deficit. It's also true that the leaner you get, the more protein you're more likely to use for fuel, as you will have less body fat available for energy use. Eric Helms, when talking about protein intake during a cut, states, it's probably a good idea to recommend protein on the high side of what appears to be optimal to ensure individuals who respond better to higher intakes are covered, since the likelihood of harm seems very low. He's basically saying it's better to err on the side of too much protein than too little protein when cutting. He also points out additional protein during a cut has more benefits beyond just muscle retention, as his own study showed with more protein, there are improvements in diet satisfaction, mood, and stress/fatigue management, as protein is the most filling macro. So to recap, if you're following the FDA recommendations, you need to start resistance training and probably eat more protein if you want any shot at a hot body. If you're looking to maximize muscle building during maintenance or a bulk, 1.6 to 2.2 kilograms per gram of body weight daily is a great range. If you're on a cut, staying at the same range is fine, but might be a better idea to increase your protein intake slightly, especially if you're struggling to stay full on your diet. That is all for this video, YouTube. If you have any questions or recommendations for a future video, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace.